Cell phones. Hey, lots of people use them. Today, the smartphones have lots of information in them. And in this country, we have the Fourth Amendment. So what happens if someone is arrested with a cell phone? Do the police get to look through all of those documents, all of that information that is in the cell phone? Well, that takes us to this week's case. Involves a real case, real man in Massachusetts. There, he was engaged in what police thought was an apparent sale of drugs on the street. When they ran a check on the fella prior to arresting him, they found that there were a number of warrants out for his arrest and unrelated things, so they arrested him. Took him down to the station house, and when they're down there at the station house, and obviously removing various items from him, cell phone. Found his cell phone, and one of the police officers took a cursory look at the cell phone and looked at the most recently dialed numbers and numbers from which calls were received. Did that because there was some evidence that he had just engaged in a drug sale with a woman, and here we have this gal's phone number appearing in a recent phone conversation. So the police used that information along with some other things in putting together a case against the man for selling drugs. The man, through his attorney, argued, wait a second, that cell phone information, you guys don't get that. You don't get that because you did not have a lawful search warrant for the contents of the cell phone. Police argued on the other side, said, wait, no. That was an incidental search to what took place. It was a situation where we just took a cursory look at the phone. We found information that related to the immediate conduct that was taking place at the time the arrest took place, or immediately prior to the arrest taking place. They, the police and the district attorney's office, said that it's similar to an analogy of stopping someone who's speeding on the highway, the car is stopped, and the police have a right to look into the interior of the vehicle, look into the trunk of the vehicle, see if there's any contraband or anything else going on, and that's a lawful search. In this instance, they said that's analogous to this by virtue of the fact that it's a cell phone, it was a cursory look, and it was only on that recent phone log. Well, the case went up on appeal to the Massachusetts Supreme Court. And there, the Massachusetts Supreme Court heard arguments on both sides, and they came away saying, hey, police officers, you are right. District attorney, when you argued saying that that was essentially a cursory look at the phone log and was not a full downloading of all of the information, that was really what took place. And more importantly, it was information that was immediately pertinent to the conduct which was taking place prior to the arrest, or the alleged conduct selling drugs, and it was a phone number from an apparent individual who was involved in that drug sale. Therefore, we find that that information, the most recent phone log, is admissible, and yes, it can be used at court. Okay. So, what do we learn from this case? What we learn from this case is that some cell phone information can be obtained. And one thing that I think we need to make a distinction on here is a lot of people think, well, when you're arrested, gee whiz, the police can look everywhere, take everything. Untrue. I mean, an analogy. If somebody's out there on the street, in plain view, he and somebody else gets into a fight, and the guy turns around, slugs the guy, starts beating the heck out of him, police break up the fight, arrest the guy who was the slugger, takes him down to the local station house. If the guy was carrying a briefcase, the police have no right to look through that briefcase, because that is what the Fourth Amendment is about. The Fourth Amendment says that we are secure in our papers, persons, homes. That means that the police have to have a search warrant in order to get things in which you have an expectation of privacy. There are some various exceptions to this, particularly when an arrest is taking place, as we have seen here now. A cell phone contains lots of information, and this is another situation where the law is being worked out. This is new technology, relatively speaking, and there is a ton of information in cell phones today. It's well known that all that information cannot automatically be downloaded and just be like taking the guy's briefcase and dumping the contents out and going through all of them. Can't do that. But how far can you go? Well, this case says the police can look at recent phone calls that were made and can utilize that information when they are trying the case later, in this instance, a case for sale of drugs. Okay, we bring you this case, like we bring you cases every week, so you can see how the law is evolving. You can see how the law will impact you. I'm David Allen.